So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. Something. Straight out of hell.
Of a language cipher. We should look for more like this.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. Now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it? Well, I think we should keep an eye out for finding signs and feed the poor bastard. My lads?
How did your friend become a dragon, Mimir?
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
Boy.
Okay. That's all you need to know.
Go!
his question, Ed. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess. Paths. I had legs. Oh, you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.